What's up, everyone? Good morning. It's another beautiful day, and today we are in Uttarakhand and we are going to climb and summit the Hemkund Sahib, the Valley of Flowers. So we are super excited. We are all good to go. It's currently, it's 4:09 in the morning. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to travel, how to get here, what time should you leave, how to trek, what to eat, where to go, everything. So,
and also our journey.
We're going to show you everything from day one to here, to hiking up and then coming back down. So let's go.
So got some snacks and energy bars for the trip, and I got myself a new headphones because the one that I have got damaged, and some chocolates.
Our journey begins from Gurgaon. Because we live in Sector 46 in Gurgaon, we had to take a metro from the Millennium City Center, which is the yellow line. Also, I want to point out that how impressed I am about the Delhi metro system. They are so clean, so organized, and quickly it has become one of my favorite metro lines all over the world. And the plan was to get off at Chandni Chowk because we are taking a train from the New Delhi train station. So the New Delhi station is quite near. You just have to walk for a few meters, and there are signs everywhere, and you'll eventually come to the train station. We got ourselves a late night train. The train left around 10:30 at night and was supposed to reach around 5 a.m. in the morning in Haridwar, and we reached around 6:30 in the morning. We quickly got out of the railway station and we started to look for shared cabs or buses of any kind that would take us to either Govind Ghat or Joshi Math. Now, after looking for some time, we eventually found out that opposite the bus stop, there are few taxis that go to Rishikesh or Joshi Math. You have to ask around and you'll eventually find shared cabs that will go to Govind Ghat. Now, they cost around 900 rupees per person, and they will only go if they find around 8 to 9 other travelers. So they'll wait for people to fill up the jeep and then they will go to Govind Ghat or Joshi Math. In our case, we found a cab that only goes to Joshi Math, and from there onwards we had to find another taxi. So right before we left, we picked up some breakfast for us because we didn't want to waste time and we wanted to get the trip started as soon as possible. But along the way, we did stop for snacks, food and water and drinks stop.
So Jim has ordered paneer paratha.
जो खा रहे थे वो हैंड वॉश कर लेंगे, खाने के बाद उनको रियलाइज हुआ भैया को कितना हैंड वॉश नहीं किया तो है
क्लीन हैंड. नाउ ही इज गोना हैव
हाइजीन कर लिया मैंने.
आई एम हैविंग अ पनीर पराठा.
After a quick lunch break, we left because we had a lot of kilometers left and it was a long journey. The drive was good. We enjoyed the weather. It was perfect weather for driving. And after a few hours, we finally reached Joshi Math. So we have made it here to Joshi Math. We left Haridwar at around 7:20. We had taken a shared cab. And it's already 5:50 now. We took a couple of breaks for food and snacks, and it was a quite a long journey. Cost wise, it cost us 900 rupees per person on a shared cab. How much does it cost for bus? The private taxis cost 8,000 for a whole cab. Buses, I don't know. I'll find it on later. Alright, so next stop for us is to go to Govind Ghat. So we're gonna find a shared cab and then head to Govind Ghat.
Yeah, we don't know the price yet. We're gonna find out and let you know.
From Joshimath, you will find a lot of shared cabs going to Badrinath, but there will be few one or two taxis that will take you to Govind Ghat. Now, unlike our first ride, in this ride they try to fit as many people as possible, and they will charge you 150 rupees per person. Now, the ride got quite uncomfortable, but the views are absolutely amazing. You will truly enjoy. This is a short ride. It takes about hour and a half depending on traffic. We did get stuck at one point because there was issue with the road. We got out of the car and we had a good time. We were chilling and enjoying the mountain views.
So we are here at Govind Ghat. We're trying to find a place to stay. It's really expensive. So they charged us 150 rupees per person from Joshimath to Govind Ghat. It was a short ride, not too long, but it's really beautiful out here. Now we're just trying to find a place to stay, and then I'll update you guys on the other stuff later on.
Okay, so the way it works here is there are free rooms and dorms in Gurudwara, and there are private hotels. And when we came and inquired, all the hotels are charging around 3,000, 3,500 and 4,000. So we booked one of the rooms and we were coming up only to find out that the basic room cost 3,000. If you want a room with geyser, it costs extra. So if you're coming here, just make sure that you inquire how much the room is with geyser, because the water is a bit cold. You might not enjoy having bath in cold water. So please inquire. But again, all the private hotels and homestays over here, the minimum is 3,000 for one room, and
as you can see, you can have three beds.
So yeah, that's what's going on. So we're gonna quickly just get ready, go for dinner and sleep, because we have a super long and early day tomorrow. Okay, let's go for food.
Now, when you get to Govind Ghat, you can obviously go to the Gurudwara and have langar if you want. You can stay at the Gurudwara, but you have to get there as soon as possible because there are very limited rooms, and if you have female in your group, they can give you a room. Now, because we could afford, and that's why we chose to stay in a hotel and eat at restaurants. In the Gurudwara, there are also open spaces where you can just get yourself a mattress, find yourself an empty spot, and you can spend the night over there.
We all are so hungry right now. We're gonna finish this really, really quick. Shuru karte hain dosto.
We also grabbed ourselves a raincoat just in case if it starts raining, so we can protect our bags. The raincoat cost us 50 rupees, and we also got ourselves walking sticks. At some places they sell it for 40 rupees, at some places for 50 rupees. You can bargain, but they'll give you for 30 or 40 rupees max. And it's day 2 and our first day of trekking. We started our day at 4:10 in the morning. We left our hotel and we had to go to the bridge. Over there now you have two options. You can either trek and go to Pulna village, which is around 4 kilometers, or you can get yourself shared cabs. Now, just like yesterday, even these cabs, they try and fill as many people as possible in that in those jeeps. Now, cost wise, it will cost you 50 rupees per person, and they will drop you to Pulna village. While you enter Pulna village, they will register yourselves. They will count the number of males and females that are entering the village, so they have a count of how many people go there.
So the cab just dropped us here. Now, down from Govind Ghat, from Govind Ghat, we took a shared cab to come up to this point, to the Pulna village. Now we are here at Pulna village. They charge 50 rupees per person for a shared cab and they'll drop you here. And from here, we start our hike. I think it's around 4:20, 4:30 almost.
It's very dark, as you can see, but it's gorgeous. And now from here, we're gonna start the climb. As of now, there's just us climbing. All right, let's do this. Chale.
Here, lift wale log. Chalo, chalo, let's go. Lift people. Chalo, chalo. We can't take break every 200, 300 meters. Chalo, let's go. We have only started the trek, but the view is already amazing. Check it out. What time is it? 5:30? Is it? I think so, it's 5:30 right now. Chalo. Now, obviously, just like every yatras, there are donkeys here, donkeys and horses, and they charge up to 1,900 for one donkey to go all the way up. Now, you can either go as a person, like it's one donkey per ride, right? It costs 1,900. You can either put all your luggage on it, or a person can go. Like you saw, there were two ladies going all the way up. Now I'm guessing they will go all the way up to Hemkund Sahib and not to Ghangriya. So yeah.
But no, the donkeys or the mules only go to Ghangriya village. Now if you start at 4 o'clock in the morning, get yourself a donkey, they can take you up. You can definitely reach there by 8 o'clock. It takes them 4 hours, 3.5 hours to 4 hours, depends. But by walking, it's going to take you much longer because we are not used to climbing and trekking over here.
So this is one stop, 7 kilometers before we reach Ghangriya. You can stop here to have breakfast, drinks, tea, whatever you want. So we are not stopping here for tea or breakfast or anything. It's 5:52 a.m. right now. So we just want to cover as much as possible. Because right now, if I go by Google Maps, showing a couple of kilometers to Ghangriya, and obviously you'll not be able to do it the way Google Maps says. But yeah, I know there's a lovely bird there. Oh, left. Hold it. Let me show. 3x zoom. Chalo. So yeah. We'll try and get to Ghangriya as fast as possible, and then once we get there, we'll make a decision if we want to go ahead and complete Hemkund or we're gonna rest there. So yeah. We're taking a small shortcut just so we can get there a little faster. A bit difficult, but not impossible. Little steeper than what we would have done, but the other route kind of goes around and comes here. So chalo, can do it. Good decision. Yeah, thodi chadhai hai, but jao.
So for this part of the trek, we did take a lot of shortcuts, because they were not that dangerous. They were pretty safe. They were quite steep, quite difficult, but definitely safe. So we took them just to cut short on our trek. So as you can see, we were definitely struggling to climb. And to be honest, this part of the trek was not even the difficult part. So I would definitely recommend anyone trying to do the Hemkund or the Valley of Flowers trek, definitely start training a month before. So get your body ready for the trek, because it's quite difficult, and I don't want you guys to get sick or injure yourself. Now, even with the trek being difficult, you will definitely enjoy the views. The mountains are absolutely stunning. You will be tired, but you are definitely going to enjoy every minute of it. So right now it's 6:15 a.m. and we are feeling great. Not tired yet. 6.4 kilometers left for Ghangariya, and we are surrounded by donkeys. So I got myself some beans for a little energy. So right now we are 3.4 kilometers away from Ghangariya, and we are blessed with such views. Let me show you. So we just made a quick stop over here, and we stopped to take some photos right here. We got some chai, and we also ordered some Maggi. So one of the best moments of this trek, chai with this view. Cheers, cheers, cheers. So after a short break of tea and Maggi, we started our hike again. We have 3.1 kilometers left, and one of the best views I've ever had while trekking. Look at this. Let me go on the bridge and show you the view. Now, once you cross the small bridge, there is a massive bridge you will see, a massive steel bridge you will see. Now, there are two roads to get to this point. Either way, we came from the below road. It's much easier. There is not much rise in elevation. But after this point, the trek definitely gets difficult, because from here, it's all climbing until you reach Ghangariya village. It will not get easy. Up until here, it was a little bit easy. It was not that difficult, but definitely after this point, it's gonna get really hard to get to the Ghangariya village. So it's 10:25 a.m. We still haven't made it to Ghangariya because we took multiple breaks. Because we have a lot of bags, and the weights are definitely slowing us down. Okay, it's 11:30 in the morning, and we just reached the helipad, and we are really tired. We started off really optimistic, thinking we'll get there by 10 o'clock, 10:30, but it's 11:30 now. And we just made the helipad. The helipad is right there. It's right in front. Over there in front. And we still have to go to the
main Gangariya village and find a stay. So definitely won't be able to do the hike to Hemkund or Valley of Flowers, but definitely looking forward to staying in one of these things.
A lot of tents, yes. I'm guessing you can book one of these hotels or these tents. So we'll figure it out.
Right now it's 12:15 and we finally made it to Gangariya, and that's how you'll know when you made it here. There's the horse shed and that's the Gangariya village. That's your entrance right there. So now we're gonna try and find a place to stay for tonight, and then tomorrow we're gonna go for the summit. So that is where we are aiming to go, Valley of Flowers. This is what they show on the internet, just fake. This is what in real it looks like. There you go. That's your Hemkund Sahib right there. That's your aim for tomorrow. Okay, so we have finally made it to a hotel. We found a place to stay. They're charging us 3,000 for a really tiny room, which has a double bed and a single bed. It took us a while to find out. A lot of rooms are sold out, so if you're planning to come here in Gangariya, get here early and find yourself a room. Now, because we are here at 12:30, we can neither go up to Hemkund nor Valley of Flowers because they stop entry quite early. So the plan is right now, we stay here tonight, then tomorrow morning we'll push for Hemkund side. So we'll take rest for some time, go for lunch, and I'll definitely give you more information about everything you need to know to get here.
Okay, bye.
So that was end of day one. We basically came back to our room. We took a nap. Wait, one second. We took a nap, woke up, went for a walk, had dinner, and now we're sleeping early. It's almost 9 p.m. The goal is tomorrow to wake up at 3:30, and then start the trek at 4 to Hemkund Sahib. Now, if we time it correctly, we are not taking any bag. Actually, we're not taking any luggage. We're keeping our bags here. We're staying here for 2 nights. So we are gonna carry a bag just with some snacks, water, drinks. So it's not gonna be heavy. We'll easily be able to complete the trek in 5 hours maybe, and then come back down, rest, and then the next day. Alright, day two of the track. We are going to Hemkund Sahib now, and so it's 4:15 a.m. It's quite dark, but people have started already to start the climb. Now they say it takes about 5 hours, so we tried to pack as little as possible. We just have a day pack with a towel, raincoat, and some snacks. Same with Kanika. Yeah, same with Kanika. She's only carrying some snacks, raincoat, and her shorts. And same with Shubhi. So challenge for us right now is to find some cash, which I'll explain about it later in the video. But yeah, there we go. Super excited. 4:15, 4:16 a.m. right now. We are pushing for Hemkund Sahib. Hopefully this time today we'll be able to finish the trek and come back and not be super tired, because yesterday with all the bags we were like really, really, really exhausted. So let's go. So we got some cash for us because we were out of cash, so this shop helped us. If you want
cache, you can find it. It's right next to, let me show you. If you find this hotel, Hotel Kuber Annex, it's right before that. You get raincoats and all sorts of stuff. They have UPI, so you can pay and get some cash. Although they do charge 50 rupees, 100 rupees. So it's upon you. If you want to bargain, they'll give you a good deal.
Now here is a very important tip. Now before you get to even Govind Ghat, or even before you get to Joshimath, do carry a lot of cash. The food is expensive here, the water bottle is expensive, the hotel rooms are expensive, because it's really difficult for them to bring all the groceries on top. So do expect prices to be higher even in Ghangria, and it gets much more expensive when you reach up to Hemkund Sahib. A bottle of water on top costs 80 rupees. Over here in Ghangria, it costs 50 to 60 rupees. Chocolates and snacks are double the price. So definitely carry a minimum of 10 to 12,000 per person. And I'm saying that minimum, because that's how much it will cost for one person for stay and food. Do carry a lot of cash. Be careful, because over here the internet does not work, your phone services will not work. We found it very difficult to even UPI that person money just so we can get some cash. And even these guys will charge you around 50 to 100 rupees. Luckily, Kanika got a really good bargain, and for every 1000 rupees, he charged us 30 rupees.
So it's 5 o'clock, almost 5 o'clock now, and we made it to this waterfall. And as you can see, it's quite a steep climb.
And from what I've been told, this part of the whole Hemkund trek is really hard. More hard than, more difficult than the one we had yesterday. So
we're trying to keep our pace slow and not rush it in. So that's the main road, and we are taking a lot of shortcuts just so we can cut our distance to half. It's steeper than that, but at least we'll get there faster. Go for it.
As we go higher at a higher altitude, we were unable to procure oxygen cylinder, portable oxygen cylinder for trek. The best resource we can get is camphor. You smell it and it will help you to catch your breath. Best source of oxygen when you're on the high altitude.
That's right. Okay, so we have completed almost 1 kilometer. What time is it? Can you check on your phone? Bobo, can you check? Hold on. It's
5:08.
So it's 5:08. And we completed 1 kilometer. And guessing it's little over 5 kilometers left. So yeah, let's go. I'll give you update every few kilometers, how it is, how we are feeling, and yeah, super excited for this trip. And I should be.
Let's do it.
Now, unlike yesterday, today's trek, as you can see, is just steep climbing and stairs till you reach Hemkund. It's not gonna get easy. Like yesterday, we were taking breaks every kilometer, but today we are going to take every 200 to 300 meters just to catch our breath and have some water.
Take a small steps, one at a time, okay? We're doing good. Chalo, aram se, use the stick to push yourself. Use the stick. Done. Chalo, aram se. Aram se. Pull yourself, hello, take the stick. Pull yourself here. Are you okay? So let me go ahead. Okay. You wanna go?
No, I have to lead.
This is
It's a little difficult, but can do it. Oh, the stick really helps. So if you're coming here, make sure to get yourself a stick.
Obviously, when you start trek, you can go along the route, or you can also try and do the shortcut. Obviously, you will cut the route by a lot of meters,
but it's gonna be super difficult and hard.
Just like over here, see, those guys cut the whole thing, so they didn't have to come across.
So we have successfully made it to the glacier point. Now this marks 4 kilometers from Ghangria village, and we have 2 more kilometers left. And if you come by a horse or donkey, they'll drop you at there because they don't come to this road. So yeah. So at this point, there's a diversion.
Either you can go from this side, it's steep, but you'll get there faster. Or you can go straight from there. Let me show you. There you go. That's the easy route, but it's gonna take you a while. Or you can take this route, but you can get there faster. But it's difficult.
So we're just taking a break. To have tea, they're really tired, and then we're gonna finish the last part of the trek. So I think we have made it to the top. We got last few steps. And that is it. It's almost done.
How are you guys feeling?
Amazing. Like, little tired, but
little? Yeah.
Little? It was worth it.
Little?
Little.
We're almost there. Little. Look at the view from here.
And finally made it. We started at 4:15. It's 11:22 now. 7 hours and a few minutes. We're here. Let me show you.
We're finally here. Oh. Thank you. So this is one of your entries to Hemkund Sahib. And then you can keep your shoes here.
So right behind Hemkund Sahib, there's also a Lakshman Mandir. It's right there, let me show you. It's Lakshman Mandir.
And that's it from Hemkund Sahib. It was a lovely trek. At the end of the visit, you can definitely visit the langar. They serve you chai, some dal khichdi, and you can definitely spend some time, have food, and then start your descent down. Now the descent down to Gangria village is as difficult as climbing. We did get a small traffic at one point because of snow, but other than that it was difficult. We had fun, we were tired, and we went to sleep.
So a slight change in plan. Initially we were supposed to go to Valley of Flowers today. The plan was to start the hike at around 4 o'clock in the morning, reach the valley by 7, spend half an hour there, and then come back by 11:30, and then from there we go straight down to Govind Ghat, and then the aim was to reach Haridwar or Rishikesh by tonight. But then yesterday we found out that the Valley of Flowers not open until 7, and then the registration and all that would take a lot of time. So the delay of 3 hours would definitely push us back, and we would not have been and we would not reach Rishikesh tonight for sure, because there are no cabs that go later on at night from Joshimath to Rishikesh. So we had to cancel our plan of Valley of Flowers. Also, I was told by the locals there, the flowers are not bloomed yet. There are not many flowers. So August would be a perfect time.
So right now I'm thinking maybe in August or late July, if anybody is interested, we would definitely come back here just for Valley of Flowers. It would be around 4 to 5 days trip from Delhi back to Delhi. So because of this delay in time, we have decided to head back to Govind Ghat and then Joshimath. We started a hike at around 5:30, and we're doing really well. We stopped for around half an hour to take some photos and videos, and we got some good shots. So that's it from this trip.
So that's it from this video. I hope you have enjoyed this. I hope you found this video useful if you're planning to visit Hemkund Sahib or Valley of Flowers. I'm sorry I couldn't show you Valley of Flowers, but that's a video for another time. But definitely this is the perfect time. It's not raining, so you should definitely visit Hemkund Sahib. It's perfect. So if you've enjoyed this video, do like, comment, let me know what you think of this video. Subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Say bye, baby.